Dear students, this is the ninth video and last video of the chapter Federalism. And in this chapter, we are going to discuss the last topic, that is decentralization. After discussing decentralization, we'll be able to understand that how the federal structure has expanded in the vertical way. And we'll also understand that how the federal structure has added one more government, that is the local government. So far in the previous video, we discussed about the central-state relationship and we came to understand that our federal system is working in a very proper way, is working in a very efficient manner. Why? Because state government and central government is working together, with some purpose. So we came to understand that central government and state government are working in a proper way, in a proper direction together. But here, what was missing? The local government. And now we are going to discuss in this topic about the local government, and we will discuss about the local government in the topic decentralization. So basically, we'll have to analyze the word decentralization. What is decentralization? So you'll have to understand, it is the word that is quite opposite to the word centralization. Centralization means here the decision making power will be centered at one place. It is centralization. And now if we are going to distribute this decision making power to several bodies, then it is termed as decentralization. Now you can see only one body was there, only one decision making body was there in the centralization. Whereas in case of decentralization, now there are five different decision-making body. So this is termed as centralization, decentralization, where the power is going to be distributed or power is going to be shifted from one hand to the different hands. In case of India, we discussed that state government was working, central government was working. Apart from that, one more government was there, and that was the local government. In village, it is termed as the panchayat government. So we are going to discuss about the decentralization. Now, you'll have to understand, although the local government, the provision of local government was there in the constitution, but it could not get recognized until 1992, when an amendment was passed. So an amendment was passed, and as per that amendment, the local government was given the constitutional status. So what does it mean? It means that now it is mandatory to have election of panchayat and municipalities at the every interval of 5 years. Before that, it was not going on. Our local body was working, but under the overall supervision of central government and state government. It was not autonomous. But this provision, this amendment in the constitution gave enormous power to the local government so that it could function in an independent manner, without any disturbance, without any supervision. No, I must not tell the word supervision, because supervision will be there. Here, it acted as the, because of this provision, now local government acted as the autonomous body. They could work, now they can easily work with some sort of independence. Now here, some of the provisions are there that was given as per the 1992 Amendment Act. So what were those provisions? The first provision was that 5 year terms of election would be there for the panchayat and municipalities. It means now it is mandatory to have election after the interval of 5 years. Second thing, that 1/3 of the seats were reserved for ST and SC, and as well as for the women also. At least 33%. In some states like Bihar, Uttarakhand, UP, the limit of 33% has been increased up to 50%. So in our panchayat, in our state, the women are getting 50% reservation in panchayats. That is why more and more number of female candidates are there, female representatives are there in the panchayat. Now after that, as there is a provision of Election Commission of India for conducting the election of Lok Sabha and Vidhan Sabha. In a similar way, the provision was made to frame a new commission that was termed as State Election Commission, and its main function was to conduct the election for the local government, including panchayats and municipalities. After that, one more provision was added, and in that provision it was written that resources that were in the state government, in the hand of state government, was to be shared. It must be shared with the local government, so that local government could function in an autonomous or independent manner. Without resources or without money, how can you work? How a government could work? So that is why the provision was made. And now for that, another body was given. That body was the State Finance Commission. So important function of State Finance Commission was to distribute the state money or state fund to the local government also. So this is how the provision was made in order to concrete the local government. So we'll have to understand that the decentralization concept is very important in the structure of federalism, because in the federalism, the relationship that was going on between the center and state, the same type of relationship is now going on between the state government and the local government. So you'll have to understand there is a proper link between the state and between the local. Now here, they all are connected in a chain, and this completes the federal structure. So now local government has also become very important, and that is why we are discussing here about the decentralization and about the special provisions that were made as per the 1992 Amendment Act. Now, I would like to go with the difference that is mentioned here. So we'll have to understand about the panchayat, and when we adopted the local government, in village it is termed as panchayat. So when we adopted the panchayat, we'll have to understand the important fact that in panchayat, there is a three-tier structure. There is a three-tier structure. First one is Jilla Parishad. Jilla Parishad. Second one is Block Panchayat. And last one is Village Panchayat. That is very important. Village Panchayat. So last one is Village Panchayat. So you have to understand. It means that our local government or panchayat is having three type of structure or three level of structure. Jilla Parishad, Block Samiti and Village Panchayat. So actual village panchayat is the main unit that is working for the welfare of the village. And to supervise this, Block Samiti is there. And to supervise the overall work of the Block Samiti and Village Panchayat, Jilla Parishad is there at the district level. So this is the three-tier structure of panchayat. So we'll have to understand this. We'll have to recognize this. Now, I would like to add one more thing. The two words are there that may confuse you. The first one is village panchayat, and second one is Gram Sabha. Or in other words, the village panchayat is also termed as Gram Panchayat. So Gram Panchayat and Gram Sabha, these two words may confuse you. So basically, you have to understand that Gram Sabha is nothing but the assembly of all the adults members, those who have completed the age of 18 in the village. So if the assembly of all the 18 above members will take place, it is termed as the Gram Sabha. And it will act as a legislature because it will supervise the work of the Gram Panchayat. That is also termed as Village Panchayat. So basically, Village Panchayat will act as a government or executive, and the Gram Sabha will supervise the work of the Village Panchayat. So this is how the work is going on in our panchayat, or at the local level or at the village level. So this is the actual picture of decentralization. So decentralization is merely a concept, and its institutional form is panchayat. So you'll have to understand, decentralization is a concept. It is an idea that power should be shifted from center to the different parts of the body. But what is the institutional form of decentralization that is very visible? It is panchayat that is presented over here. No? So our topic is now going to end here. So we came to understand the concept of federalism and how the third level of government is very important for the federalism. We also understood that because without the local government, we cannot think about the development of the overall country, because development starts from the grassroots level. So basically, we discussed about the development of grassroots level under the overall ambit of federalism. Thank you.